You got a mic 187?
We're here in Seattle for this afternoon's matchup between the 49ers and the Seahawks. These two head coaches today, they know each other, they respect one another, and they desperately want to beat the other.
Yeah, of course they do. Shoot, these coaches are just like players. They can't wait to run across the field and shake the hand of the other guy and go, yep, got you today. And look, you get all this experience, Jim. They're going to give their players a chance to win it. They're going to put them in good situations. It's going to be fun to see how it turns out.
And they have this return completely covered, tackling them inside the 15. Lines up here. Here's the quick toss. A gain of 14.
After that long run, that running back deserves a break. Go over to the sideline, let a few guys pat you on the rear end and tell you how good you are, and then get a little oxygen and get back in the game. What a run.
The 49ers lined up in the pistol. First and 10, leaning on that running attack again here on first down.
Well, we got the mojo flowing today, don't we? You start out the game, it's early, you pick up a couple first downs, and you think you can't be stopped.
Here they come, back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. Makes the grab and keeps the ball moving down the field. That's a first down catch. They've marched right onto the field with this opening drive, and they're moving the chains with regularity.
They sure are, and I think it's time for the defense to quit sitting in there in that bland defense they're running. Take a chance and try to stop this drive.
The 49ers line up in the pistol offense. First and 10, Gore taking it right up the middle. Gains 12.
What a job by the offensive line that time. This running back hit the hole at full speed, and the defense had very little time to react. And that's how he got in the secondary, made a couple guys miss, and gets down there and gets a long run.
Frank Gore is in the backfield, trying to get it outside before the defense is set. They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Tossing it to the running back. They knock him down, and he's still 2 yards short of the first.
That's a terrible read by the running back. It's a short game, but it's all his fault. He picked the wrong hole. He should have cut it back. He didn't, and that's why he was tackled.
The 49ers will approach this play from out of the pistol. They feed him the ball again. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Even though the defense knows you're probably going to run the football, it's third and short. If you run hard, all you need is a little bit of a lane. We see it there, able to get the first down.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. First and 10. Throws to the right. Interception.
You gotta stay aggressive on the defensive side. At that time, the defense did. Even though the offense was going in to score, they come up with the big play, and they get the interception inside their own 20-yard line.
First down here. They run the counter play.
And they're going to run it right.
Good job by the running back that time, finding the open hole and picking up those extra yards.
Harvin's going to get set in the slot for this snap. First and 10. Back to the ground. They tackle him for a loss.
So many things you can do on first down. And what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Looking for a receiver on the left side here. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Good job by the receiver that time. Getting that extra couple yards, gets a first down. They are marching. Let's see how the defense reacts.
This play set up by the long gainer.
The give.
Running to his right.
And this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time, they stopped that run just for a short game.
And a little screen set up here. Sticks to his hands. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Don't see enough of this in the NFL anymore. The out route. Everybody's afraid to throw it. They want all those little safe dink and dunks inside, but that is a nice throw and catch by the quarterback and wide receiver. Perfect defense call that time. They allowed the catch. The coach on the sidelines going, well, what else do you want me to do? We had the guy double covered, and you still couldn't make the play.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. And that's going to do it for the first quarter. We'll be back from Seattle for the start of the second after the break. The Seahawks will attempt to carry over that momentum after that huge play before the end of the first. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. They motion the receiver around to the other side. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. They break through, tackle him behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Second and goal from the 8. He's looking to the right here on this throw. 6 in the books.
And what a touchdown there for the offense. The quarterback just fires that football in there. Look at the defenders around the receiver, but the receiver big enough, tough enough to go up in there and make that catch.
And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Gore is lined up in a single back formation. He gets to toss it. Shakes off the hit.
Good job by the running back on that long run. It's one thing to have talent, but the first thing you need as a running back is vision. You have to pick the right running lane. That's what he did that time, able to get down the field and get that long gain.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. First and 10. They pick up the first down with that reception. Nice tackle.
Well, it doesn't look like much, but it really serves the purpose. Picks up the first down, and now they have a chance to open things up.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Wasting no time. Here's the toss to the outside. Runs out of bounds.
Well, if you're a good running back, when there's not a lot there, you find a way to make some extra yards. Here in the red zone, it's even more important.
Offense lines up here. And the give to Frank Gore. It's Earl Thomas who makes the tackle.
I think you got to be a little more creative in the red zone than this. When you just line up and run the football like that, you're not going to get a lot of yards. And that time, they just got a short gain.
Offense lines up here. Kaepernick's going to keep it on the sneak. Powers his way across. Touchdown.
You got to be able to take advantage of the quarterback sneak. If the defense doesn't line up properly, find the weak spot and go there to score.
Extra point is good. The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. Percy Harvin will be returning this one. And he's going to give his team great starting field position on that return.
Well, a lot of good things happen on both sides of the football this time. How about that return by the return team? Good job, good blocking. Look at the speed of that guy running. They get the tackle from behind and stop the touchdown.
Out of the shotgun formation. Working that left side.
Tipped away.
Lots of ways to attack cover two. There's no doubt about it. You can throw it underneath. You can pump fake the safeties, make one of them move, and still throw it deep down the field.
Harvin's lined up in the slot. Second and 10. Harvin's going to take the handoff now. Let's see what they do on this third down situation. Wilson's got it in the gun. Looking across the middle. The pass falls incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series. The Seahawks will go with the pistol on this play. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
What was the defense doing that time on that fourth down try by the offense? Disorganized, not ready, and they give it up.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. They're running the option. Here's the pitch.
What a nice run by the running back. Picks up big yards, and he did everything that time. He picked the proper hole, gets through it, and shows that speed to get the long game.
First down here after the run. An open receiver on the right. Pass is made and it's incomplete. The hit jars the ball out. The 49ers lined up in the nickel. The throw to the left.
Good job by the defense. They are all over the throw by the quarterback. They almost pick it off in the end zone. Well, that's a big opportunity miss when you drop a pass like that.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. So now a third and 10. Pitches it back. Good solid tackle. Short of the first. And now we've got a fourth down situation.
Shotgun.
Russell Wilson has it under center. It's intercepted! The tackle was made.
Linebackers nowadays are so talented. They can just do everything. They're strong enough to stop the run, but how about this interception? Good job, good reading of the quarterback, and a nice catch.
Moore is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Looking to the right side and throwing. Kaepernick gets it to Vernon Davis.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch and gets a first down.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. Frank Gore gets it here. Gains five.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying, we're tougher than you are, and we're just going to come right at you.
Offense lines up here. Second and five. Throws to the right. He's got the grab, and he's got the first.
Another first down by the offense. The defense is definitely getting fatigued, and when you get fatigued, you cannot think, so look out.
Here's the quick toss to the running back. Gets past the first wave.
You know, when the linebackers, when they see that the offensive formation is shifted to one side, well, as a linebacker, you got to play to that strong side and try to get up there and stop the run.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. And that's a 2-yard gain.
Jim, sooner or later you get these situations, you got to throw the football. As we have seen today, they keep trying to run it, but there's not much there to go.
Second down and eight. Escaping the pressure. Third down. Kaepernick still got the football after the play fake. The reception easy, wide open, bringing the play to an end.
Good job getting the first down by the offense. And look at the defensive players on the sideline cheering their teammates on. Keep us on the sideline a little longer. That's what they're hoping for.
This will be the eighth play of this drive. It's handed to the running back.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Wide receivers are bunched up. Second and goal from the four. Ball's going to be incomplete. A hit knocked the ball out.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
Third and goal at the four. Throwing now to his left. What a catch. Touchdown.
It is so disappointing when you're down near the goal line and you don't score. Well, the offense doesn't have to know that disappointment this time. Good job, good play call, and a beautiful throw by the quarterback for the touchdown.
The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. They're setting up return. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. One more snap in halftime. First and 10. Looking for Percy Harvin. And it's incomplete. That does it here for the first half. Seahawks trail in this one. We're back here now in this one, where the 49ers are leading by 7.
Let's find out the latest from the sideline. Danielle Bellini is there reporting.
I got a chance to quickly speak with Coach Carroll during halftime. It's an uphill battle for his team guys as they head into the second half. But he says it's not the time to get frustrated. There's no reason to try and be a hero. Just follow the game plan and things will work themselves out. I'll send it back up to you guys.
Thanks, Danielle. And now we'll go to the field. Harvin's a receiver in the slot. First and 10. Now slashing to the right side, looking for room.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Second down now. Throws the pass. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
The Seahawks in the pistol. The wide receiver shifting around in motion. Now first and 10. And he'll go to the left. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left, and he's intercepted.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
In the backfield, single back set. Ball is snapped and the quarterback tosses it to the outside.
That's what you want to do, just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving, keep the defense guessing, make them react instead of attack.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play and they stopped it.
Wide receivers stacked up on this play.
Quarterback flips it to the running back.
Nothing too exciting here, just plowing ahead, getting closer to that goal line.
Well, they're trying to find out if this defense has the courage and toughness to stand up to them. So far, they haven't. This defense, they better pick it up if they think they're going to stop this offense.
Third and goal from the 2. Trying to work that left side.
Oh, bad decision on time by the quarterback. He tries to force the football into the end zone, and it almost gets picked off by the defense.
A short field goal try on the way.
The kick is through for 3.
Never take it for granted. When you're trying a field goal, a lot of things can go wrong. But good execution that time by the offense and a good kick. 3 points.
He's got a chance to return this one. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game. Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense. Well, that's the new NFL. Just keep throwing it behind the line of scrimmage and see if the athletes can catch it and make some yards. None there that time. A loss of a couple yards.
Of course, it's 3 and out.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has the injury update.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Seahawks team official. Percy Harvin's injury seems to be relatively minor, or at least it's minor enough that he'll be back on the field shortly.
Nickel formation for the defense here.
What a catch!
Well, they're a gambling football team. They like to take chances. Even though they're down, it's in the second half. They take another chance. They go for it on fourth, and this time they got it.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Percy, touchdown. This game is tight.
Well, we're talking about some of the fastest humans on earth. And we take into account you can't touch them or breathe on them. That's how they're able to get open and make so many catches.
The Seahawks now lined up for the extra point. And it's a fake. And so they convert it here on the two-point try. Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. What a touchback. Pistol formation. First and 10. He takes it on the counter.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Offense lines up here. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. Easy catch there. No one near him.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you got that defense guessing.
Ohio! Ohio!
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, it's just a race against time, isn't it? When the defense blitzes, can you get to the quarterback before he has time to recognize the blitz and throw it to a receiver?
The offensive line gets in position. Can they protect their quarterback?
Sacks are so hard to come by in the NFL, but how about this time? The defender gets the sack. That is two sacks in two plays.
So they get to the quarterback on that last play. Third down coming up. Getting sacked again.
First off, that's a terrible job by the offensive line. But let's give this defender some credit. How about that? Three straight plays. He takes the quarterback down, and all three, that was awesome.
Andy Lee will be punting this one. Harvin will return the punt. They pounce on him there. First down, offense readying for the snap. They're going to go counter to the right. Has the first down, now looking for more.
Well, the long run that time, and there's a lot of reasons why they got that long run. But the biggest one, the good blocking up front, but what patience for the running back. He did not panic because it took a while for that running lane to develop. When it did, he saw it, he hit it, and he used his talents to get down the field for the big game.
The pass complete. The stop.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Baldwin's in the slot. Jackson's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
Good job by the defense. They are all over the throw by the quarterback. They almost pick it off in the end zone. Well, that's a big opportunity missed when you drop a pass like that.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. He's looking to go down the field here.
There's a sideline pass. Incomplete. It's ruled.
Third down on the way. Makes the catch in the open field.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
And he takes it across. It is a touchdown.
That was just an awful job, wasn't it, by the defense? I mean, it's first and goal. Well, you know it's going to be a run, or I think you should be playing run. The defense not ready. They get overpowered, and they give up the running touchdown.
Got the touchdown. Got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do. And you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
And a touchback. The 49ers come out in the pistol. First down and 10. He's going to the left. Has some space to work with. Shakes off the tackle. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
Good job that time by the running back. I'm sure he's a little winded after that play. He showed that speed getting out there and picking up those extra yards.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. And here he goes. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Well, the defensive coach is going to be upset after this play. After that long run, terrible angles, and really just a lack of hustle by the defense gives up the long run.
Colin Kaepernick under center, eyeing that left side. Touchdown, San Francisco. The 49ers can take the lead with the extra point. Driving extra point is good. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. He will run this one back. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
First and 10. They feed the running back. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
He'll fire it out to the left. The Seahawks now move the chains.
Well, there's nothing like a play-action pass. When the offensive linemen make it look like it's a run, the linebackers are all near the line of scrimmage and easy to throw it down the field for that completion.
And Rice is lined up now as a slot receiver. The quarterback will hand it off.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second down and 6. The ball is jarred loose. This one's going back the other way.
That was just a terrible job by the offensive player that time. Protect the football. No excuse for letting it fumbling the football in a situation like that.
The 49ers lined up in the pistol. First and 10 as they go ground here, running to the right.
Good job that time by the running back, getting down the field and picking up big yards.
Here they come, back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. First and 10, toss to the outside. They bring him to the turf. If they're going to have any chance at all here late in the fourth, the defense must make a big stop and give the ball back to the offense.
It's a mindset. It's a culture. That's what you got to create when you talk about running the football. And when you get it going the right way, you can grind a defense up. Another first down for this offense running the football.
Leading and with possession of the football, a good place to be at this point in the game. First and 10. And they go back to the ground. Runs to daylight for the touchdown.
You got to have good vision to be a good running back in the NFL. And that vision means following the right guys. The running back does it, leads to a touchdown run.
An extra point is good. The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. He's got a chance to return this one.
There is nothing like a good return when you talk about special teams. Good blocking, the speed of the returner gets down the field, and after that tackle, now they have good starting field position.
Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win. Got a hand on it, and it's incomplete.
Good job by the linebacker that time. Saw the receiver coming in his area, read the quarterback, and in wonderful position to knock the pass down.
Dagger!
The quarterback realizes time is a factor. They need to put some points on the board. Complete, and the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down, keep those chains moving, give yourself three more opportunities.
Jackson's dropping back to pass once again. He brings it in.
Now there's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, a double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
2-minute warning. First down following the long play. Looks to his left. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Second down and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
That's interesting as you watch the receiver trying to make that catch. He knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
Dagger!
Offense lines up here. Third and 10. Touchdown! And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
Hard to cover these tight ends when they get into the end zone because they're fast, they're nimble, and they're big. So even if you cover them, they push off and get the touchdown catches.
They get set, looking to convert on this two-point try.
So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
This kick will stay on the ground, avoiding a big return.
And the tackle is made at the 41.
Line up in the pistol offense.
First and 10. Counter run here. Breaks free.
On his way.
The 20, the 10.
Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
First down here after the run.
Back to the ground, and he's in.
Ah, you just love it as a quarterback. You get down in there, and it's first and goal. If you score, now you don't have to sweat the fact that, man, what are we going to do if he gets the third down? You don't have to worry about it.
Good run. Nice touchdown.
Well, you don't see it too often, do you? You see these missed extra points, and the first thing you think of is you look up, you do the score, and you go, how is this going to come back and bite them? Because a lot of times it does. It changes strategy as this game goes along.
He'll start his return.
And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a 49ers team official. Frank Gore's injury doesn't appear to be anything too serious. Yes, he'll be sore tomorrow, guys, but that's not going to stop him from returning today.
Tavares Jackson under center. First and 10. And he's taken down.
To me, this is a no-brainer. Anytime that clock is running and you get sacked in a situation like this, under 2 minutes and you're behind, you use one of those timeouts to stop the clock.
Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
Good job that time, Jim, by the defender. He hit that receiver so hard, that football came flying out. That's why it's incomplete, the big hit by the defender.
Fourth, fourth.
Third down.
You ready? Ready.
He'll throw it over the middle. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Drop back, shotgun formation. Makes the grab. He's brought down right around the 43-yard line.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
Rocks him with that hit, and the ball's going to fall incomplete.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football's arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
And now they'll try over again on second down.
Challenging the defenders to the right side, and he's going to be tackled right around the 35-yard line.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So you got to be able to throw the football and pick up some first downs.
The Seahawks coming to the line still have all three of their timeouts here in the fourth quarter.
Well, that's a sign of a good defense. When you can sack the quarterback, when you're just rushing the defensive lineman, you don't need any tricks, you don't need any blitzes. Man, that's talent.
They are set back in long distance territory after that sack. Second down coming up. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
This drives coaches crazy. They get a wide receiver open down the field on a post route, and what happens? The quarterback just overthrows it.
The Seahawks come to the line of scrimmage with two timeouts to play with. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Incompletion there. Just not quite able to get the feet down.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Jackson's going to take it from the gun. Looking to the right side and throwing. That's an interception.
Well, nowadays, your linebackers, they got to be able to do everything. They got to be big enough to get in there and stop the run, and also athletic enough to be able to get in position and make an interception. Good job by the linebacker.
One more snap and we can call it a day. Takes a knee. And here we have second down. The Seahawks have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. The 49ers come to the line. First down marker at the 40. This will be the final snap. Takes the knee. This was a good game to watch today. Competitive all.